Hi there, it's Nathan Carver from Zimco Instrumentation here today. Talk to you about Tescom pressure regulators. So what I hope to do today is kind of go through some of the basics on different types of regulators. There are three types. There's a back pressure regulator, a pressure reducing regulator, and also a differential spring bias regulator. We're going to only go through the two today because the other ones get pretty complex. So we're going to talk about the back pressure and the pressure reducing regulators. So a regulator's purpose is basically to balance forces, and there's quite a bit of calculation that goes into that, but I'm going to hopefully simplify some of it for you. So to start, we'll go with the pressure reducing regulator. I have a couple of those sitting here beside me. So in a pressure reducing regulator, what it does is it controls a downstream pressure. So for instance, you have a high pressure helium bottle that has to feed into an H2S analyzer, something like that. That high pressure helium bottle is going to blow up that analyzer if it goes directly to it. So we put what's called a pressure reducing regulator in between there that'll take that high pressure and convert it down to a much lower pressure. And that gives you a pressure reduction and therefore safety on site and a balanced set point that makes that analyzer not get any damage done to it. To go to the next one would be a back pressure application. So with a back pressure regulator, you're gonna see some people use them as kind of like a manually adjustable pressure relief valve. What it does is basically takes an inlet pressure. So you're controlling, instead of downstream, you're controlling the upstream pressure. With a back pressure regulator, a common application would be on a CNG vessel. Let's say that CNG vessel has to stay at 400 PSI. If it goes above that, there's gonna be problems. Some people will put a back pressure regulator on there that will be set to 400 PSI. And as that vessel tries to go above that, it will vent off on the other side of that regulator. There's being kind of a pressure relief valve, but more of a manually adjustable in case that set point is ever to change. And it gives you kind of a rundown on the two different types. We actually offer one of the best brands in the market. We offer the Emerson Tescom brand of regulator. The Emerson name is pretty well known. We are exclusive to that particular product. And some of the features of the Emerson Tescom, they have quite a diverse catalog selection, thousands of part numbers, many different possibilities. We can control air pressures up to 20,000 PSI. We can control hydraulic pressures up to 30,000 PSI, and so on and so forth. The CVs, which is your orifice size or your what they call your coefficient value on the in these regulators, they range right from a 0.02 up to a CV of 20. We're even working on a CV of 30 right now, so just some interesting flow capability there too in some control valve applications. Even though we have thousands of that catalog options available, we also have what's called the modification feature. So any Tescom regulator can be modified to meet your application. If you have very complex applications, say the big hydrogen boom that's happening right now, where we need to get the right metallurgy, we need to get the right sealing mechanisms, we need to get some pretty complicated balancing forces happening to keep your set point stable on a vehicle or something like that, this is something that comes into play with our modification features from Tescom. That gives you kind of a rundown there. Now, what I wanted to do as well, I wanted to run you through a bit of an unboxing. I have a pressure regulator here with me, a pressure reducing regulator from Tescom. Just gonna bring that into the shot here. We got our Tescom pressure regulator. This is the box that will come in. So this guy here, when you open up a box, be it a valve, a regulator, whatever the case may be from Tescom, inside that box is going to be a plastic shielded item. And that's part of Tescom's testament to quality. It's their base quality assurance requires that every single piece that leaves their factory must be O2 cleaned. There's no extra cost for that. It's nothing like that, but it is something that has to be O2 cleaned. It's just part of their QA. On the regulator that you see, you're gonna get your etched in part number. There's a build date etched into the unit and also a serial number. And that gives us full traceability on products for warranty purposes, things like that. It gives you an idea of what you'll see inside the box with a Tescom pressure reducing regulator. But beyond that, I mean, there's quite a bit that goes into these things, and I understand this video only goes over a couple of little details, but if you do have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. I believe we're putting my email in the below description of the video here. If you like the video, drop a like, and share it, and go ahead and subscribe. We'll bring some more content like this to you.